versus FXDFW. I'm telling you, man.
Yes.
I feel like after this latest patch, Lunchables might be the best player in here right now. He might be the best player in the game right now.
I think he was always the best player in the game.
Shots.
I'm just saying. It's not shots against anybody. It's just me just saying. When I think about how this guy's mind works, it's next level. He truly understands this game. And he makes a great choice here with Marth. I think they're going to go for the neutral start at 50.
Button check.
Okay. So, no, honestly, I think that Lunchables is one of the, if not the best player in the world right now. It's the way his mind works is just phenomenal. He has... Let me ask you this. Whenever you look at frame data, what do you think? Do you think of the numbers themselves? Or do you think of a kinesthetic feeling to them? Or do you think of both?
Oh. I mean...
And this is exactly it, is that when you look at Lunchables, he knows the frame data inside out. He has the knowledge, he sees it. And there's also an added element of, I can feel something that's 3-frame, 4-frame, 5-frame. He just knows, he understands, and he has the feeling of what's the punish.
That's very, like, Savant-esque, you know? Like,
exactly.
You know, when Savants mention, like, when they think about numbers, they see, like, shapes and things like that.
Correct.
That's crazy.
Exactly. But that's the thing is that with Lunchables is that he's a phenomenal player. And when you look at him and his results and you look at his play style and you look at the way he thinks, there is no doubt in my mind that he's one of the best players in the game right now. The problem is he's still growing up. It's like you see him and you look at him, you're like, this guy is a demon. You see just someone who can absolutely create the worst nightmares for people when playing this game like that.
Dude.
But when you put him in front of a big crowd, sometimes he's going to have problems, and he's working on fixing that.
You know what he is? He's like a young Goku, and he just needs his Master Roshi.
He really is just a young Goku right now, and I have no doubt in my mind that he's going to get to those Super Saiyan God levels. It's just going to come with time.
No.
Wonder, on the other hand, very smart player, very cerebral, comes from a StarCraft background, and so actions per minute, definitely nothing foreign to this guy.
Oh, yeah. No, he knows how to push the buttons efficiently.
Yeah.
He knows how to do it, and that's why Fox is a perfect pick for him, to say the least.
Ooh. So this is the thing that's so important is knowing when you can go for those grabs. Because with Marth in this particular matchup, you have two. Your mentality should always be about the positioning. That's what matters more than anything else. Because as soon as you see Marth, and Umbreon does this to me all the time, is that he doesn't care about the damage, he cares about the position. As soon as he can take you off stage, you are forced to use Firefox. You are forced to stay in position for a short period of time, and that's the time where he's going to drop down, bear you, push you that much further out, and finish your stocks.
I mean, not even bears. From Lunchable's side, we're seeing a lot of fares, just enough to blow out the candle and make it so that Wonder is put in a position where he cannot recover.
Absolutely, and it's just that ability to go out and stuff people so quickly and efficiently.
I mean, I look at that last match, and it just feels like Lunchables just meticulously picked apart every single stock.
Absolutely, and that's something that we talk about is, and Wonder and I mentioned this a little bit earlier, is that when you're playing against Lunchables, he knows the options that are available very easily, very quickly. And let's just say we do, Wonder made a fantastic analogy. He said, you know what, let's imagine that there's 10 options in neutral, which there's definitely more than that, but let's just say we imagine that there's 10 options in neutral. Lunchables was going to cover 9 of them, and if you don't execute that 10th one just perfectly, he's going to punish you and you are going to lose your stock.
Oh, man.
His punish game is phenomenal.
I mean, every aspect of his game is phenomenal. The one thing that's holding him back, honestly, is those tourney nerves. And especially as we are 2 weeks from Low Tier City 3, it's going to be a matter of whether or not he can keep those in check. Because, I mean, if he's in his room playing against you, you're going to lose. But the minute that the crowd goes against him, man, it's just rough stuff because he's just a boy.
He's just a boy. And he's growing up into a man. We'll see what he can bring to the table. He's doing a great job so far, that fair to the edge. I want to see what if Wonder can get in here and capitalize because he's been getting thrown quite a bit. As soon as he's jumping in, whether it's empty jump or Nair, or even just out of pressure, I've seen Lunchables doing a good job of getting grabs and consistently finishing stocks.
Oh, yeah. And now that the percent is even lower, we can maybe see some more combo-oriented play from Lunchables. At those higher percents, it can be a little bit more tricky to really get some long, elaborate combos going.
Up throw up air. And he's going to continue to do those up airs. He saw the opportunity that Wonder was trying to drop through the platforms and retreat, and that's where the dare was there.
Oh, yeah.
Drop down shine? No, he's going to hold the edge. Good stuff from Wonder.
Yeah, Lunchables, I think, was predicting that Wonder would be doing a particularly early recovery.
Right.
An early roll onto the stage, and that's why we saw that early recovery from Lunchables. Wow!
Wave
caught
dash.
Him by surprise with that F-Smash.
That was really... And this is the thing, is like in neutral, there's something that you can do where you don't have to press a button. You don't need to do anything. You simply are in the vicinity of someone, and they know these are your primary options. And you know where the tipper's at, and whenever they drop shield to do a rebuttal, because they think it's their time, that's when they get smashed.
Man, that was Wonder's time to shine, no pun intended. That was excellent execution overall, bringing this down to two stocks apiece.
Absolutely. Wonder's playing fantastic right now.
Yeah.
Two stocks apiece. I like what I'm seeing from the Nairshine pressure. He's trying to see if he can cross him up to avoid those shield grabs.
Exactly. That's why you're seeing him overshoot those nairs ever so slightly just to avoid getting grabbed, like you mentioned before. But that time, Lunchables is able to sneak in the grab, and look at this set of up airs. Doesn't quite find the forward smash afterwards, but he gets another grab. Down air? Oh, just barely whiffs it. Wonder, maybe with another chance, he's back on stage.
Let's see how he approaches. I think he's sitting at 128%. It's very much where his options are limited. He's trying to just hang on, and Lunchables saying, no, you're going to the Shadow Realm.
That was a beautiful conversion by Lunchables. I love the angle that he swatted him with.
Yeah,
excellent,
absolutely.
Excellent play, making the most of that sweeping downward arc.
I like what I'm seeing from Wonder. He's been doing a good job of that Nair Shine pressure. I'm a little bit hesitant and weary to see those up smashes in neutral that are whiffing, because as we talked about earlier, it only takes one mistake for Lunchables to really go in there and get a full punish. That is an excellent up smash off the top. Team Rocket on the stock.
That was the one mistake that he was looking for. That early, early get up into that up smash. Perfect, perfect execution by Wonder. Bringing this down to one stock apiece. But Lunchables, he gets the grab, gets the F smash.
Hold steady, waits for the punish opportunity. It takes him back to the side of the stage. Now, he didn't get damage. He got positioning.
You're right.
He didn't get stocks yet, because he knew he's going to cash in now.
And no jump from Wonder means that Lunchables takes that with a JV2. But man, gotta give props to Wonder for hanging in there and bringing it that close.
That was phenomenal. Taking socks off of Lunchables, doing a fantastic job in neutral, and knowing when to go out there, go deep, and fish for those shine spikes. All critical elements of the game.